Hey, what's up, everyone? It's your boy Matt Diazabal coming at you with a new album review. And today I'm checking out one of the hottest recording musicians of the 2020s/2010s, and that is Billie Eilish with her latest album, Hit Me Hard and Soft. She is one of the biggest stars to come out from the 21st century, with coming out with huge hits. Like Bad Guy and Ocean Eyes from her earlier career and everything, working with her producer and older brother Finneas, and just making hits after hits after hits. She's become a global sensation that everyone from Korea to America to Canada to Brazil knows who she is, and she's like been an unstoppable machine. From incredible songs to head-scratching experimental songs, you're going on an interesting journey for sure with this new album. In the first half of this album, she's coming out with some real strong, soft, emotional bangers about love, pressures of life, and just dealing with yourself. And it's just very, very like refreshing and very, very relatable that anyone can listen to this and just like, oh, instantly connect with the music. Her wonderful vocals and her great words are also backed by great production and musical arrangements with this album. And I would say a prime example of one of these songs that has great vocals and is backed by some great music would have to be the song The Greatest, because it starts off really slow and it just builds up into this huge, climactic, like amazing song. So I want to show you a clip of The Greatest for you. She just has so much power in these vocals that she's performing here. So, like I was saying, the first half of the album, like on the song Skinny, she has some really soft guitar strummings that are combined with her soft vocals to create a nice, relaxing vibe. The way she's hitting her notes on when she's saying cry are just really nice, and she uses a live crowd to really elevate the song. There are times when her vocals are a little bit too airy and too whispery, but it gets made up for it in the solid chorus. Great lyrics. It's a great opening song with the use of different traditional instruments like violins and everything to create such a warm feeling. And then you smoothly transition to the second song, Lunch, which has more of a modern day pop sound and rock band vibe to it with the bass and drums. With the band sound and everything, it's kind of giving like Western California like vibes, which makes sense because she's from California. And then she's back with her like typical Billie like vocals, and they just sound super clean. And weirdly enough, it's a very generic sounding song, but because the production is so good, it just sounds better than normal. And then we move along to Chira, which has a thick and low bass sound to it against her soft vocals. It creates a really cool contrast and everything. And I like how the song slowly creeps in with some synths and everything that just sound really cool. It just puts a big smile on my face because it reminds me of Daft Punk so much. And again, it's a bit of a slow burn of a song, but the progression is really nice here. It has a really, really cool, like, cyberpunk vibe to it, and it just really kicks at the end. So I want to play a clip of Ichiro for you as well. So nice. It has on Birds of a Feather, this is like the lead single from the album and everything, and has a nice whimsical beat to it, and it has that soft Billie voice touch that's nice. And surprisingly, it kind of has like a Taylor Swift chorus to it. Really sweet lyrics, and just again, the progression of the music in the background and everything, it's just really great, and I can see why it was one of the lead singles for this album. Then we have the second half of the album, which like dabbles into some different sounds and vocal performances, and they can be either really interesting or sadly, just I think straight up bad. Like on the song Diner, she has like a weird echoey effect on her vocals, and it just makes her sound really weird. And the musical choices in the background are really off-putting. Like they're using a recorder in the background, and it just doesn't mesh that well. It just feels like poor circus music. So I'm gonna play a clip of The Diner for you. I'm waiting on the corner till I saw the spinner leave. It's easy getting over and I landed on my feet. I came in through the kitchen looking for something to eat. I left a call of cards so they went over. It doesn't really feel like Billie, I feel. I know she's trying to experiment, but that's just weird. if we roll it back to track seven, the guitars have like a reverb style to it that gives it a more like lax feeling. It kind of reminds me of like a chill Amy Winehouse song for some reason. And throughout this song, she does some weird vocal inflections that make her sound like a little mouse and everything. And they go through different like genres of music. Like at one point, it sounds like something from the 1920s, and then you get some 80s synth party music, and then some 2010 like 303 Warped Tour music. It's a real like hodgepodge of different sounds that just don't mix well, I think. And if we move it along to track nine, Bittersweet, it has like some high synth sounds to it and everything, with some deep low beats underneath and everything. She has like a really soft and small vocal pattern here that works well with this beat, I think. But overall, the song is just kind of like okay until the very end when it really kicks in with some huge like organ playing and everything. But it's overall just like a very okay song. But by the end of the album, she's able to bring everything back to like a real Billie, like Eilish type style music vibe and everything with the final track, Blue, because you have a really strong vocal performance from here and really good sonically arranged music here. The pacing of the song is well executed and it just feels really, really good. It's flowing nicely. And I think it was a really good way to end the album with like the popping beats and everything with her haunting vocals. It just really helps play the album out nicely. Just like the album title, she's hitting you hard, she's hitting you soft. She's getting you with some good songs, she's getting you with some bad songs. There's a good balance here and everything. And I think the experimentation is really good because it's helped pushing her into new boundaries that either she needs to try and experiment and see if she can work with those sounds or not. Because if you don't try, you don't know how good or bad you're going to be in a particular style. So she gets big points for experimenting with her style, and but also making some good quality Billie Eilish songs that are just going to be probably timeless down the road and everything. And I commend her for what she's been doing on this album. I think it was a pretty solid album overall. So I would say it's a decent to solid 8 out of 10. Let me know what you think about this album. Let me know if there's any albums I should check out. Check out this video over here. I'm Matt from Diazable. Thanks for coming on by. And until next time, guys, bye.